Welcome to Cooking with Sean, where savory and spice makes everything nice. Today, we're gonna cook a pan-seared duck breast with a port and cherry reduction sauce, garlic mashed potatoes, and a simple grilled asparagus. Enjoy. Just gonna take some grilled asparagus, trim it, clean it, put it in a Ziploc bag with some Wegmans basting oil, probably about a tablespoon or so, some fresh black ground pepper. I'm gonna seal that up, let that get happy for about 20 minutes before I grill it. And then I'm gonna transition to the potatoes because they take a little bit longer, about 20, 25 minutes. So I'm gonna get those nice and happy, and then I'm gonna show you how to grill those really, really fast so they're tasty, and then I'm gonna plate. Okay, for my mashed potatoes, I like to do these two different ways. If I'm using a ricer, I like to put the garlic cloves into a simmering pot of heavy cream. But for this, I'm gonna use a ricer. So I'm going to actually take the garlic, I'm gonna smash it and put this in the boiling water where I'll put the potatoes and a bay leaf. I like to take my garlic and cut off the little hard edge there. And then I like to smash it with my hand. It makes it easier to peel the garlic, the whole garlic cloves. And I'll do this for the remainder, for the rest of them. And then I'll put this right into the boiling water. And for 25 minutes, I'll put this, the garlic, some bay leaves, and potatoes that I just took and cut, some Yukon Gold potatoes, at Wegmans they call them butter potatoes, put them right in the water, let them boil for 25 minutes. I'll take it, strain it, put it into a ricer, and I'll start to get a nice puree type of mashed potato for the recipe. So garlic, whole cloves, about 8-9 cloves in the boiling water, salted water, with bay leaves and the potatoes. Some garlic, whole garlic cloves. My potatoes. Be careful of the boiling water, don't burn yourself. And let this cook for about 25 minutes. And then I'm gonna remove the bay leaves, and then I'm gonna mash the potatoes with the whole garlic cloves in the ricer. So you'll have this nice garlic mash. Again, if you're not using a ricer, take the whole garlic cloves, put them into the simmering heavy cream, and it creates like a garlic heavy cream sauce, which is incredible once you add it to the mashed potatoes. But we're gonna try something new today, and we'll come back to this in a second once we begin rendering down the fat of the duck breast. So one of my favorite pieces of meat is duck. Right, and the fat is rendered right, it has an incredible taste. So I'm gonna start with scoring the duck breast. I'm gonna do it in cross ways just to get it a nice score. But be careful not to cut so deep to the meat. If you're looking for a really good knife, I recommend the website Webstaurant, like restaurant. They have really good prices, and you get a nice score on the meat. We're gonna start with the skin side down for about 5 to 8 minutes, and we're gonna reverse that over and flip that over to another 5 to 8 minutes on the flesh side. Do a nice medium rare duck, and we'll do both duck breasts that way. A little salt and pepper. My doctor said not too much because of my health, but I don't always listen to the doctor. You can do the same thing to the other side. Again, a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper. Some people like to remove the tenderloin. I'm fine with it right on during the cooking process, but I'm gonna do 2 duck breasts. I'm gonna cut those when they're all done, and then I'm gonna move to the preparing for the port wine reduction. So we're gonna get ready and get the start the pits and cherries for our port reduction sauce. I use one of these like straws you use for shakers for the gym. It's nice and sturdy, and it gets the pit right out. You can do that for all 8 cherries. Just take that right to the bottom. Oop. And if you hold it nice and tight, it pops right through. There's the pit. A little trick someone taught me once. And you can, don't have to buy an expensive cherry pitter. Again, this is just a straw from one of your gym straws. I'm gonna take these, pit it, and then I'm going to simply cut the cherries in half and use that to make a sauce. I've also cut up a large shallot, and we're gonna use that with some port wine, some chicken stock, and make a nice reduction sauce for our duck breast. All right, so what you have here is you have our duck breast, which I'm gonna sear, skin down first for 5 minutes, and then I'm gonna turn it over for another 5 to 8 minutes for medium rare. And then this is for our sauce. We have some port wine, which is a New York State wine. We have some homemade honey from a friend of mine, Diane. Chicken stock, about a half a cup, some shallots, and the cherries. This is gonna make our reduction sauce for our duck breast. Ready? All right, we're gonna put our nice sear on our duck breast in a nice hot skillet. We're gonna put this here on low to medium for about 5 minutes. You wanna get a nice crisp on that skin. And then at the same time, we're going to transition and start making the potatoes so they come out at the same time. I did put a little bit of butter in the pan. You don't have to do that because duck makes it its own fat. But I want to use the fat from the butter and the duck for my reduction sauce. I added just a little bit of butter to the pan, and let's see how that works out. And then we'll come back to this in a second, and we'll prepare the mashed potatoes in a second as well. All right, so I've drained my potatoes. And I've strained them, put them back into a hot pot. What it does is it allows the heat to evaporate some of the moisture so you don't have really messy and runny potatoes. Remember, I had bay leaves in here. They've been taken out, but I still have these big cloves of garlic in there. So when I run through the ricer, you'll have this nice potato, creamy potato and garlic mat. I have 2 cups of heavy cream, some freshly grated Parmesan cheese, and butter waiting for these potatoes. They're gonna be incredible. A little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper, and that's gonna make up our garlic mashed potato. We got the duck breast working, the port wine reduction is ready to go, and we're gonna grill the asparagus at the last minute because those are gonna come out nice and hot. They've been simmering in that, or actually marinating in that Wegmans basin oil. All right, you'll see a nice crisp on the skin there from the stuff. Just flip it over, I'm gonna go about 5 minutes. All right, so this is the ricer. Little device allows you to get the potatoes a little more fine, comes out like that on the end, sort of like really, really fine. You don't have the major clumps. I just continue to work those down until I get all the potatoes with that garlic. Oh, it smells absolutely incredible. So to those creamy potatoes, I added about a cup and a half of heavy cream. I'm gonna add some salt and pepper, and some freshly grated Parmesan cheese to these garlic and potatoes. You get a chance to see the consistency there. And also, I want to say that my kids love black truffle oil. So I often add a dab of black truffle oil to my potatoes. It gives a nice earthy taste and a creamy texture. So I'm gonna add a little bit of that to them. To there. I'll add the cheese in a sec. So I use my truffle oil, I'm not gonna use much butter. I get some nice, fresh parm. I get my cheese from the public market as well, at the Italian cheese shop there. Great people. That is incredible. Again, a little salt, a little pepper to taste, and those are my garlic mashed potatoes. All right, Lex, I'll put more cheese in. My kids love parm in their potatoes. A lot's there. Who's counting calories tonight? Get some salt, some pepper. Salt. I gotta do it, Lex. All right, potatoes, Nellum style. And we had the duck breast. I'm gonna add 1 large shallot. And don't worry about those. The best part is stuck to the bottom. When I add the chicken broth in a couple minutes, or a minute, you'll have an opportunity to see it just decaramelize. I'll add the cherries, a little bit of port wine, some of that local honey as well. I wish you could smell this. It's absolutely incredible. I love shallots. Shallots are one of my favorite. Oh, yeah. There we go. People ask why I cook. The smells, the sounds. A little Harry Belafonte in the background. Absolutely incredible. You can see this pan. It's been deglazed. It's nice and clean. All those pan drippings from the duck. Making that really, really nice. Turn my heat down to medium low. About 8 halves cherries. About 2 tablespoons or so of port wine. My big hands, heavy pour. And then some of this homemade honey from a friend of mine. That is absolutely incredible. Thank you, bees. Let that cook to a nice thick sauce. And I'm gonna get my grilled asparagus going. So turn the heat up on that port wine, shallot, cherry, and honey sauce. Let that go on high heat for about 2 to 3 minutes to reduce. And then I'm gonna also start my grilled asparagus. It's snowing out, so I'm not going outside. So I bought a little inexpensive indoor grill. And we'll get these going. And then we'll plate them. Asparagus, mashed potatoes, garlic, truffle oil, fresh parm, and duck. All right, so you have your asparagus grilling. I put 2 tablespoons of cold butter in my sauce. It'll help it be a thickening agent, and it'll give it a nice cream to it. A little more fat to the pan. Then we're gonna start plating. Duck breast. Oh, it's a perfect medium rare. Kind of see that there. Looks delicious. Nice crust on the skin. That's my piece, and this is my piece. We're gonna fan out the bottom part onto the plate, add some sauce and asparagus, and go from there. I'll be back with you in a second to see the final plating. That was incredible. My first vlog, pan-seared duck with a nice cherry and port wine reduction, creamy garlic mashed potatoes, and grilled asparagus. It was an incredible journey. Thank you, my Nailmator fans. Make everything nice with savory and spice. Peace.